Hey there, Measure Geeks! So you want to start measuring your user activity with GA4 events, but there are custom events as well as recommended events. And what is the difference between those? Well, let's figure it out together. So to implement our recommended event, please make sure that you have your Google Tag Manager implemented on your website, as well as your GA4 installed via Google Tag Manager. If you do not know how to do that, I would definitely recommend checking one of the Julian's tutorials, which is really great. Okay, but before we start, let's talk a bit about GA4 event types. There are four event types in GA4, and we have automatically collected events, enhanced measurement events, recommended events, as well as custom events. Here you can check the Google documentation, and I will also attach a link for you. And in this session, we will focus on recommended events, right? And you can see that these events have some predefined names and parameters. And according to the Google documentation, they can unlock some reporting capabilities. Well, this is interesting. And just to sum up, we have automatically collected events and enhanced measurement events, which are collected kind of automagically. So everything you have to do is to simply install GA4 on your website and make sure that you activated enhanced measurement. That's it. Whereas recommended and custom events require your implementation. So although recommended events have some predefined names and parameters, you still have to configure those manually. Why do we have those names at all? You can view work with GA4 as communication. In order for the tool to understand you, you have to feed it with the correct data. And this is why Google introduced some kind of language. So you know that they have been heavily investing in machine learning, and in order for the algorithms to understand you, you should use some names that are suggested by Google. But of course, you can also configure custom events. And there are some grammar rules. And now, a quick question to you. So who wants to be a GA4 expert? What is the naming convention for GA4 events? These are exactly the grammar rules. We have camel case, kebab case, and snake case. And yes, this is snake case. So this is something to keep in mind when you name your events and parameters. But now, the most exciting part, let's start our implementation. Before you implement any event, you should always check the Google documentation. And here you can find a list of recommended events. And you can have a look at those. And in my case, let's say I have this sign up form and I want to track it. I'm going back to the documentation and I'm checking the list. And here I can find this sign up event. Awesome. So this means I can use this name. And if I click on this sign up right here, I can also see the parameter for this event. So here you can see method. But it's not required, so you can configure your event without a parameter. But if you want to send some additional information about your event, you could do it with the help of parameters. So these are some data points that describe your events better. Great! I checked the Google documentation and I can see the name and the parameter I can use. So now let's move to implementation. And what do we have to do? Yeah, we have to submit the form here as a test. And voila. Here you can see that we are lucky because we have this URL. So this is the thank you page and we can easily track it, right? So I can simply copy this bar because each time a user submits a form, he or she gets redirected to this page and I can easily track that. And let's go to the tag manager. And this is where I can create my new event tag configuration. And here I can select which tag type. It should be Google Analytics GA4 event. And here I should provide the configuration tag, this one that I configured before, and event name. Again, if we go back, you remember, this is where you can find this sign up right here. Let's paste it, or you can type it. And event parameters. I want to send some additional information about this event. And specifically, I want to use this parameter, which is called method. So let's paste it here. And value, let's say I have multiple signup forms, and this one is a web form. So I can use it. You can provide any value you want. It can be sunshine, flowers. But of course, we're working with analytics with our event, and we should provide some proper names that are useful for your analysis. Okay, here we go. And let's configure our trigger. And let's click plus. So when should our event fire? In this case, we have this page. This is our success page. And I will select page view, but I want to track only some page views. Specifically, I want to track this one. Awesome. So let's provide the name and let's save our trigger. And we should also provide the name to our deck. It's good to have your own naming convention, especially if there are many people working on the project, in order to keep everything clean and tidy. And let's save our tag. Great. And now we can test it if it actually works. Let's click preview. Let me go back actually. Where is my signup form? I will do it this way. And we should provide the URL here, right? Great. And you can see tag assistant connected. And what do we have to do? Let's fill it in one more time. It's crucial to test your implementation. It is very important in order to verify that everything works correctly. And here we go. And let's go back to our tag assistant. So here you can see tags fired and this is my event. Great. And let's go to Google Analytics and we can also check it here. And if we go down, this is where we can find our debug view right here. Here we go, sign up. And if I click on it, I can also see my parameter, which is web form. Great. So you managed to configure this event correctly, if you see that. So let's go to the tag manager and we can submit right here, provide a version name. So let's say GA4 event sign up. Of course, you can provide proper name. I'm typing fast and here we go. So we publish our changes to make them live. And now another question. We have this parameter. Should we register it additionally as a custom definition? Although logically, all recommended parameters should be there, right? Well, I prefer double checking just in case, and I absolutely love this tool and I can recommend it to you because I'm working with it on a daily basis because it's, for me, at least for now, it is impossible to keep everything in mind and to remember all the parameters, all the dimensions and metrics. So here I can type method. Here we can see general, and if I click on it, you can see the definition. Populate this dimension by sending the method parameter with the signup. Okay, cool. And I can see that it is available in the exploration section. Let's have a look actually to make sure that it is there. So let's go to explore and I will click blank just to check. And here we have dimensions. So I can click plus and I can look for my method. Oh, and here we go. So we can see general method and I can import it and I can build my report. Of course, it takes some time for the event to get registered in GA4, up to 24 hours. But later, you can use it in your explorations to look at your events and parameters. I hope you managed to configure everything correctly. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Please don't forget to subscribe. And if you want to check other GA4 videos, you can find them right here. Happy measuring, guys!